What's up, guys? My name is Brandon, and today Apple released iOS 15 Beta 5 to registered developers about 2 weeks after the release of the fourth developer beta. And for public beta testers, you should be seeing Beta 5 within the next 24 hours, and I will keep you posted over on Twitter when that does get released. Now, in addition to this iOS release, we also got iPadOS 15 Beta 5 and tvOS 15 Beta 5. We did not yet get watchOS 8 Beta 5 or macOS Monterey Beta 5. But we should be seeing both of those very soon, and they may very well be out by the time you're watching this video. But anyways, of course, in this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS 15 Beta 5 and what's new in the software. So let's go ahead and start off with the size of this update. So you can see here on my iPhone 12 Pro Max, the update came in at 1.05 gigabytes, and this is coming from Beta 4. So it does depend on the version you're coming from, and of course the device you are installing this on, but it should be around 1 gigabyte. So let's go and check out the build number. If we go into our settings, let's go to General, About, 15. You can see there the new build number is 19A5318F. So we do have an F at the end of the build number, which indicates we do still have quite a few betas to go as expected. And if we go down to the modem firmware, you can see that has also been updated to 2.09.05. So if you were having issues related to the modem, those could be solved in this update. It's always nice to get those modem firmware updates. So anyways, what's new here in this fifth beta? And the first thing is actually an app icon change. So I'm going to go ahead and bring over beta 4. This is going to be beta 4 throughout the video on my left. Beta 5 throughout the video is going to be on my right. So we're going to take a look at the weather icon. So take a look at that. We have a slight change to the weather icon here in beta 5. So in beta 4, you can see that's what it looked like. And now in beta 5, here's what it looks like. So it's a little bit darker, a little bit different overall, but it's kind of hard to tell unless you have them side by side. But there is a slight change there to the weather icon. We also have some changes inside of the control center. So first off, you could see that the camera icon has been changed to match the rest of iOS 15. So before, it had the shutter icon on the left-hand side right there. You can see the shutter icon, but now it is removed. And in beta 4, they removed it from the lock screen. They updated the icon in the lock screen. And now here in beta 5, they've updated it inside of the control center with the toggle right there. And then also right here for sound recognition. So you can see right next to music recognition, we have the sound recognition. That was the old icon. This is the new icon here in beta 5. I like that a lot better. Also down here, you could see that for announced notifications, we have a new icon as well. So this was the old announced notifications icon down here in the bottom right. And now in beta 5, that is the new announced notifications icon. So Apple made quite a few changes to the control center glyph icons here in beta 5. And I like each and every one of them. We also have a change when we go to turn off our iPhones. I'm going to go ahead and turn off both iPhones here on beta 4 and beta 5, and you will instantly see the difference. So right there under slide to power off, you can see we have a new little text down there that says iPhone findable after power off. So before, this is something we saw as we turned the phone off, like as it was already turning off, it would just kind of show it at the bottom. But now in beta 5, it shows it before you even turn the phone off, which I think makes a lot more sense. That way somebody actually knows it's going to be findable after you power it off, besides just showing them as the phone's already turning off and they can't do anything about it. So I like that little change here in beta 5. We also have a minor change to the Safari application on iOS, and we also have a separate change on iPadOS, which I'll show you here in a moment. But the small change on iOS 15 beta 5 is actually in the address bar. So as you guys know, with the new address bar in iOS 15, it just, when you scroll down, it just collapses and gets smaller and kind of blends into the bottom of the screen. Well, now in beta 5, you will notice that the reload or the refresh icon is no longer down there until you expand that address bar to the view like that. So when you're scrolling, you will see that the address or that the refresh icon is no longer down there, which I like, because in beta 4, there would be times where I would accidentally tap on that when I'm just trying to get into the address bar right there to type in a new website or something. So I like that small change here in beta 5. And on iPadOS 15 beta 5, you can see a slight difference to Safari. Just the overall look of it looks a little bit different here in beta 5 when we have the classic tab view. So you can see up top how it looks like that. Here's what it looked like in beta 4. So you can see beta 4, just take a look up top. This is a screenshot I took right before installing beta 5. Here's beta 5, beta 4, beta 5. So just a slight difference to the whole top section of Safari here in beta 5. And while we have the iPad right here, we do also have another change I wanted to show you guys. So if you go to your settings and then go to home screen and dock, you can see we have a new toggle here for use large icons. And when you tap on that and you go back to the home screen, you can see, of course, that the icons are very large. So if you have bad vision or, you know, for whatever reason, you want to use large icons, you now can do that on the home screen. All right, so now going back to iOS 15 beta 5, if we go into our settings down here and then go to notifications and then go to scheduled summary right here, you will see that we have a slight change right here. So first off, you no longer have to take the extra step to tap on apps and summary for it to show up. It now shows up right here on the main screen. And then we also have show next summary. That's a new toggle right here, and it says show the next summary in Notification Center before the scheduled time. So you could turn that on or off right there as well in beta 5, whereas that did not exist here in beta 4. Also, if we go into our focus settings right here and then we go into an actual focus, so I'll just go to recording a video, you will see a difference right away. So up top, we now have a kill switch for that focus mode. So recording a video, we now have the on and off switch to turn on or off right there. Whereas before, it would just show it. And when you tap on this, it just takes you to where you can edit the little glyph icon and the color. Well, now there's a new section here in beta 5 that is name and appearance. So it's more obvious that you can change that now in beta 5 without having to click through here and then change it. So when you go here, you get the same submenu. We also have some very interesting changes inside of the Siri and search settings. So if we go down, it used to just show Siri suggestions right here, but now it looks like that's been changed up a little bit. And I'm still trying to figure out exactly what this is, but you can see that now it shows content from Apple. So it says show in lookup and show in spotlight. And it says Apple can show content when looking up text or objects in photos or when searching. So that is new. And then also suggestions from Apple instead of, I guess, Siri suggestions. So it now says allow notifications, show in app library and spotlight, show in sharing, and show in listening. And it says Apple can make suggestions in apps on home screen or on lock screen or when sharing, searching, or using lookup and keyboard. So those are all new toggles here inside of the settings and Siri and search. So pretty interesting changes there. And then lastly, inside of our settings, if we go to iCloud and then to iCloud storage, you can see that the app icons right here on the left-hand side have been reverted back to their normal size. So in beta 4, they were a little bit smaller, but now in beta 5, it's back to being their normal size. Now we also have multiple new splash screens here in beta 5. So you can see this is the new one for photos. So it shows shared with you, memories, and richer info. And of course, these new splash screens basically just tell you what's new in the update for the specific application. So that is the new splash screen for photos. We also have one here for maps that shows interactive globe. So it says discover the natural beauty of the earth with a stunning new interactive globe, which is of course when you zoom all the way out. We have all new city experience and immersive walking directions. Then we have this one for home and it says home key. So tap to unlock the front door with your iPhone or Apple Watch. So that is a new feature. And I'm not sure if that's been added with this update or if it's just in the splash screen, but it does show home keys right there, Siri enabled accessories, and HomeKit secure video. And then we also have one for podcasts. This basically just says the shared with you feature in iOS 15. That's really all it shows here in the splash screen. And then we also have one for translate right here. So it says conversation views, auto translate, and system-wide translation. So just showing off the new translate features here in iOS 15. So all of those are new splash screens here in iOS 15 beta 5. So those are all of the new features and changes I found so far here in beta 5 after having this installed for about an hour and a half. So if you guys want to see even more new features and changes, which I'm sure I will discover over the next few days, make sure you stay tuned to my follow-up video, which will be released on Saturday like I do every single Saturday. But anyways, let's move on to the bug fixes. So this is something that Apple didn't really mention too much about in the release notes. So Apple usually mentions the bug fixes in these release notes, but you can see here they did push out the beta 5 release notes, but it doesn't really show much. It basically just shows, you know, one bug that was resolved, but it shows in beta 4 it was resolved. So I'm not too sure if there are really any bug fixes in this fifth beta because nothing is really shown. It really just shows a lot of known issues. So I'm sure there are bug fixes, but the release notes don't really tell us too much. So I'm hoping that the Safari bug that some people are still having when you close out of multiple tabs at the same time, it crashes Safari. That was fixed for me in beta 4, but some people said it was still, you know, there for them on beta 4. So hopefully in beta 5, that is fixed. And then also issues with private relay have been fixed for me on beta 4. But again, some people also said they're still having that on beta 4. So I'm hoping that those two bugs are fixed and maybe some more as well. So Spotlight Search, you know, that bug still never came back after that was fixed in beta 4 for me. Hopefully that does not return either. But as far as overall bug fixes, Apple really doesn't mention too much. So it appears that we may have to wait for beta 6 to see some real bug fixes and stability updates. And as far as bugs go, I have had a few bugs in beta 4. And after reading those release notes, I would not expect those to be fixed here in beta 5. Number one is going to be for the notification sounds. So those are still off for me, like with Snapchat. Sometimes I'll just get the default sound instead of the, you know, unique Snapchat sound. And people are having that as well for things like ESPN. I've also had issues with Twitter crashing a lot. Now I know that's partly due to the developer and, you know, it's their application. They should update it so it doesn't crash. But it seems like even after all the updates, Twitter is still crashing. So hopefully we see a fix for that pretty soon. And then also banking applications are still not working properly. I did test this out and my Face ID is still not working properly here in beta 5 for my specific banking application. So I'm assuming that those we're also going to have to wait and see, and also have to wait until probably close to the final or maybe even the final release of iOS 15 for banking apps to, you know, kind of perform as they should. Now, as far as the performance goes, performance feels excellent here on beta 5. So the performance on beta 4 is pretty good overall. And I was expecting beta 5 to improve on that even more. And so far, it just feels a lot better. I mean, I don't know what it is, but everything feels much better here on beta 5. It's definitely the best feeling beta so far, as it should be. But this was also backed up by the great Geekbench scores I got. So I ran a Geekbench, you know, shortly after installing this. And take a look at these scores, some really solid scores here on this fifth beta. So we got a 1606 on the single core and a 4129 on the multi-core. And just for comparison, this is what we got on beta 4. So we got a 1599 versus a 1606 and a 4115 versus now a 4129. So some really good results here on beta 5 in the Geekbench test. And I know that doesn't really tell you too much, but overall, like I said, it even just feels a little bit faster and smoother here on the fifth beta. So I'm hoping that continues to get better because it feels really good and pretty much on par with iOS 14 right now. But one thing that is not on par with iOS 14 is the battery life. So battery life on beta 4 was pretty bad for me on every device. So I'm hoping that beta 5 gets better, but it might realistically just not happen until the final few betas, which could still be weeks away. However, now that I'm taking a look at my battery life here, I've been recording this video for about 30 minutes now, and I still have 100% battery remaining. So we could actually see better battery life here in beta 5, because I don't remember my battery life being that good, you know, for 30 minutes using my phone nonstop for it not to go down a single percent. I don't remember that happening on beta 4. So we could actually see better battery life here on beta 5. Just from my overall, you know, first impressions, it seems like battery life might be improved. So again, stay tuned as usual for my follow-up video, which is coming on Saturday, like it does every single Saturday. And I will let you guys know if that good battery life persists and stays good, especially on my 12 Pro, where I make phone calls and do all that. So that'll be interesting to see. All right, so now what is next for Apple? So we've been on a 2-week beta cycle for iOS 15 ever since the first beta, but now is usually when Apple switches over to a weekly release schedule. So we could very well be seeing beta 6 next week, like maybe on the 17th. And then if that does happen, we should see a beta every week. So the 17th, the 24th, you know, the 31st, the 7th, all that, you know, of course it could be a day or two off. We could even skip a week sometimes, but from here on out, we could very well be switching over to a weekly release schedule. So anywhere between, you know, 7 to 10 days, we could see a new iOS 15 beta leading up to the final release of iOS 15, which is now, you know, almost a month away. It's crazy how fast this year is flying by, but we should see iOS 15 sometime in mid-September, if I had to guess. I don't think it's going to be late September. I think it's going to be mid-September this year, but we'll have to wait and see on that. Of course, it does depend on when Apple is going to unveil the new iPhones as well. But of course, when we do switch over to a weekly release schedule, that's usually when we start to see a lot of enhancements to the performance and the battery life, and we start to get a little bit less of, you know, new features and changes because Apple's, you know, saving those for like the 0.1 release. We start seeing a lot more battery life improvements and things like that. So that's what we should be expecting from beta 6 through beta, whatever we end up going to, 10, you know, who knows. So anyways, that is what it's looking like so far for iOS 15. Of course, I will keep you guys updated on the iOS 15 beta schedule over on Twitter. So if you're not following me over there, make sure you go ahead and follow me. I'm just at Brandon Butch over there on Twitter. But anyways, guys, there you have it. That is iOS 15 beta 5. Let me know what you guys think about the software down in the comments below. Let me know how it's been running for you. Of course, return to this video in a few days as well. And let me know in a comment how it's been running for you, if it's fixed any bugs, how the performance, how the battery life is. Let me know all your thoughts down there in those comments below. And of course, if you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe for the latest iOS 15 coverage. And of course, my follow-up coming on Saturday. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.